I want to talk about magnesium and how long it stays in your body. Now, there's certain minerals that go through the body pretty quickly. Other minerals don't. Like, for example, sodium, iron, and calcium tend to be retained in the body, but magnesium, potassium, and zinc are not held very long. Now, what determines the retention or the recycling of potassium is how healthy your kidneys are. If your kidneys are very, very healthy, you may only lose, you know, 0.5%, versus if they're very, very unhealthy, you will lose a lot more. There's a huge gap on how much your body is going to hold versus excrete. And because the kidneys have the ability to get rid of excess magnesium, magnesium is rarely toxic to the body, but you're going to get rid of between 0.5 and 70% of your magnesium within a 24-hour period. So it's very important to keep the magnesium coming in the body. The RDAs for a female for magnesium are between 310 and 360. In a male, it's 400 to 420. But you have to realize the RDAs are only there to prevent deficiencies. They're not the dose that you should normally have to maintain a healthy body. So these numbers should be a lot higher. In fact, I think they should be at least 500 to 600 milligrams per day. But the average American is only consuming between 200 to 300 milligrams per day. Now, if we also add in all the other diseases, like for example, diabetes, the need for magnesium goes way, way up because you simply do not retain magnesium if you have blood sugar problems. Also, if you're drinking a lot of alcohol, that is going to severely decrease the ability to hold magnesium. Now, when you consume magnesium from the diet, you're only really absorbing between 24 to 76% of the magnesium from the food. And that really varies because if there's digestive damage in your colon, that could be a factor. If there's a pH deficiency of hydrochloric acid in your stomach, that can also alter your absorption. And there's other reasons as well. About 50% of all the magnesium in your body is stored in your bone. It's a reservoir. So if you're not eating a lot of food with magnesium, your body will just pull it from the bone. That could be a problem if you keep doing that. And some of it is stored in the muscle. Probably the number one symptom of magnesium deficiency is fatigue, because your mitochondria, the energy factories of your cells, need magnesium to create ATP, which is the energy currency of the body. So we need magnesium for energy. If you crave chocolate, you could be deficient because there's a lot of magnesium in chocolate, and your body will tend to crave those things that have a certain nutrient that it's trying to pull in. Also realize that 99% of all the magnesium in your body is inside the cell, and only 1% is outside the cell. So if you were to get a test for magnesium in your blood, you really would not get the accurate picture of what's going on. You want to get an intracellular test. I'll put a link down below of a company that can test your magnesium. It's intracellular testing. Why are you deficient in magnesium? Well, number one, it's the empty calories. If you're consuming refined foods that strip all the magnesium out, that's the number one reason why people are deficient in magnesium. Just basically refined sugars, grains, things like that. The next reason is they're consuming a lot of phytates. Phytates are located in the fiber of grains. So if you eat a lot of oatmeal, which by the way, has a good amount of magnesium, you're not going to be able to absorb it because of the phytates. Phytates bind the magnesium and it will not let you absorb that magnesium. So if you're consuming wheat products, other grains, legumes, they're all high in phytates. And typically whole grain cereal has a good amount of magnesium, but it's loaded with phytates. So you're not getting the magnesium. If you have kidney damage, that's going to alter your ability to absorb magnesium. Now you might say, well, I don't have kidney damage. Well, did you realize that the number one cause of kidney damage is diabetes? And 90% of people that are pre-diabetic don't even know they're pre-diabetic. And probably 70% of the population has insulin resistance, which is a pre-diabetes situation. And if you have insulin resistance, that not only could block magnesium from going in the body, but also over time, it can lead to some kidney problems. And the last reason why people are deficient is they don't consume enough chlorophyll type foods. Chlorophyll at the center of it has magnesium. It's similar to our blood chemistry where we have iron, but chlorophyll, it's like the blood of the plant. So if you're not consuming a lot of vegetables and salads, that could be another common source of why you need more magnesium. So one of the first symptoms you'd get from a magnesium deficiency would be fatigue. Another one would be a palpitation, or your heart starts to go out of rhythm, your muscles feel weak, and there's quite a few symptoms. If you want more information about the symptoms of a magnesium deficiency, I put that video up right here. Check it out.